In this video,
oh wow,
this is a great ramen. We are trying possibly the most luxurious ramen in Singapore. That's one of the most umami-packed ramen broth ever, along with the restaurant's Teppan-Kaiseki. So let's check out this newest Japanese restaurant in Singapore. Wow, this place is beautiful. Honestly, MIYOSHI By Fat Cow has one of the most unique locations in Singapore. It just feels so beautiful and tranquil, and it's located in Sentosa Island. So I feel like I'm having a little getaway trip from Singapore. So MIYOSHI By Fat Cow is located at Mess Hall, and it used to be a military outpost, hence the colonial vibe. So it's our second visit to MIYOSHI, but honestly, this location is just so unique that just coming here and exploring the surrounding is already worth your trip. Super cool location. All right, time to eat.
Look at this place, it's just so beautiful. I love all the woody elements.
Wow, and there's a really food lying on the table. I like that. So MIYOSHI, it's a new restaurant by Fat Cow, which is super popular for their Wagyu donburi. And Fat Cow is listed under the Michelin guide, and I love it because I remember my wifey, she treated me a Wagyu omakase like 2 years ago for my birthday, and it was great. So we're trying the Teppan-Kaiseki, but before that, we're trying probably Singapore's most luxurious ramen. So on the left, we have the lobster ramen, which costs $88. And on the right, this is beautiful too. We have the Wagyu dry ramen, which costs $58. I'm getting super excited because I love ramen as Japanese, but we normally spend 700 to 1,000 yen for a bowl of ramen, so this is probably the most expensive ramen bowl I'm having. So I'll start from the lobster ramen before it gets soggy. So I see, wow, it's beautiful. Cherry tomatoes, some type of greens, lobster. Oh, this one's huge. And I can tell it's beautifully charred. There's some cream as a topping and little prawns. It might be sakura ebi. The white leek and the noodles. I'll start from the soup first. Just the smell. It's very, very crazy. Oh wow, that's one of the most umami-packed ramen broths ever. The lobster flavor is super strong. The cherry adds nice acidity and sweetness, and the cream chef pour over at the last. That makes the dish more round. And of course, I've tried lobster. Oh, that's good lobster. It's snappy, it got a nice texture. And now see the noodles. Cooked perfectly, sucks up all the nice broth. Whenever you slurp, you also get in the amazing aroma. Just the smell of this ramen is insane. And I noticed the little shrimps add a nice crunchy texture. Let me try the leek. Super juicy and crunchy. Now let's eat everything in one bite. When I first heard about this ramen, I was kind of skeptical if all the flavors were, you know, kind of match, but it magically does. Super nice bowl of ramen. All right, next let's try their dry ramen. This is fun because it arrives like this, and if you open, you see the beautiful dry ramen. So there's charcoal grilled Wagyu niku miso tamago minced Wagyu miso paste and some greens. Wow, this is so exciting. The beef looks so beautiful. And they gave you lime, so I think I'll splash that over my dry ramen and then mix everything together. That is so appetizing. And I didn't realize how much meat this ramen got because of the minced meat and of course the Wagyu. Okay, let me try the Wagyu. You guys can probably tell from my reaction, I'm a meat guy. The lobster was great, but the Wagyu, oh my god. It melts, so tender and sweet. And now I'm chasing it with the noodles. Man, this is a great ramen. I love how the noodles, you can see it's kind of getting charred because of the hot plate. So it comes hot and it gives you this, in Japanese we call this okonge. The okonge gives it a nice aroma and texture. All right, done with our ramen, moving on to the kaiseki. Wow, this area is beautiful. So this area is reserved for the people eating the kaiseki, and we're trying the dinner omakase, teppan kaiseki omakase, of course. All right, so starting out from the zen side, the appetizers. So it's my second time to MIYOSHI, and I remember the chawanmushi was very nice. Wow, look at how soft that is. That's how I remember. Super silky, and the wasabi adds a great accent, got a hint of truffle aroma, and look at this beautiful spring roll. So there's ama-ebi, sesame cream cheese, kaiwane wrapped in thin rice paper with wagyu tartar.
いただきます.
The ama-ebi, which are the sweet prawns, it just melts and bursts out this sweet, amazing sauce. And the wagyu tartar, this is beautiful too. I think it's raw. This one also instantly melts. Blast of wagyu, umami. All right, I think I am ready for the teppan-yaki. Okay, the chef's here. Okay, next up, Wagyu Sawani-wan. Oh, the smell. I remember this was my favorite last time I came here. The broth is so good. It's a combination of bonito and oxtail. And there's a deep umami to it. And this is the beef. Cooked right in front of us. I can see it's kind of like still pink because you never want to overcook good quality wagyu. This is A4 Miyazaki-gyu, which is champion of all the wagyus in Japan. And inside I see shredded carrots and mushrooms. This is very good. Wow. The wagyu is so tender, melt in your mouth. Just the right amount of fat, and I love all the crunches from the veggies inside. It's so comforting yet powerful. Delicious dish. Amazing. Guys, so far it's such a fun experience. Just coming to this location is entertainment. Exploring this historical yet modern new location in Singapore. You can book the restaurant from the link in the description box below, and I think we're doing a video promo, so I have the promo details there too. And right now you see no people because they let me film at 3 p.m. which is a weird timing. But the first time I came here, it was a weekday evening, and it was quite packed. So I recommend you to book if you're interested. Oh, and that's just scattered, but I remember this was so good too. Fresh Hokkaido scallop. Wow, beautiful. So it's now cooked and it goes in this pot and he's gonna smoke it with the straw. And this gives the hotate a great aroma. In fact, I already smell it. It's such a great smell. Next up, straw smoked Hokkaido scallop. There it is. And just so sweet and smoky. Like it got this intense smokiness from the straws. You really don't need soy sauce, but I think I'll dip it. A bit to try. And I forgot to mention that you can also order sake peri. It's the Junmai Ginjo cod done. It always goes so well. Actually, sake is meant to be paired with food. So you always want good food, good sake, and that will make you happy. So what do we have next, chef?
Teppan style sukiyaki do. What beef is this? A5 hira.
Wow. Nice sound. And look at the marbling. And instantly, the fat comes out like crazy. That was so fast. There goes the truffle. That's a lot. Okay, teppan style sukiyaki. First of all, this is beautiful. A5 hida ribeye. Wow, that's super premium meat. Sprinkled with black truffle. Wow, this bite is so luxurious. Fat keep on coming out. Wow. And the sauce they provide is it's egg yolk sauce. So that's where all the richness come from. So creamy at the same time. And the truffle, amazing texture. And the aroma, of course, was so good. The wagyu. Again, Miyoshi, it's my fat cow. So you know they provide you one of the best wagyus in Singapore. All right, uni soba. This one's beautiful too. He semi-cooked the uni, almost like a steaming method. And the sauce is niku miso and soba sauce. So it's very meaty and sweet. いただきます. The soba, beautiful texture, beautiful aroma. The buckwheat, so nice. And the deep fried burdock, amazing sweetness, crunchiness. And the uni. Oh. Just makes you smile, you know, it's just so sweet and nice. God, this is crazy. Oh, so energetic. Moving like crazy, you know, this huge abalone. Almost like he's trying to escape, but he's going to be soaked in salt, right? Oh, here it is. Do you think it's still alive or?
Yeah.
Still alive, huh? Oh, no, okay.
<laughs> 早く食べてあげましょう.
That's my abalone.
Wow, oh, konnichiwa.
Going straight on the teppan.
Oh, they're so plump.
This is the beauty of teppan yaki, you know, you get to see the chef prepare all your food.
And the smell, you know, directly goes to your nostrils, and you get to eat it when it's the best. Because normally at restaurants, it gets prepared in the kitchen, and you know, sometimes the staff, they don't pick up the food as quickly as you would like, right? But here, the travel distance is very short, so you get the food at its best thing.
はい、これがさっきまで生きてたアワビですね。もう超新鮮。いただきます。あ、もうバターの香りがめちゃくちゃ。It's
just so plump, chewy, and tender at the same time, and juicy at the same time. And you only get this when the abalone is super fresh. I love how it's very lightly seasoned. They don't overdo anything at all. There's some salt and butter and soy sauce, so you get to enjoy the sweetness of the abalone. And I also love that they don't throw away the innards. It's just so creamy, slight bitterness, but goes really well with the abalone and of course the sake.
Okay, yuzu butter mud dyed. First of all, I love how crisp the outside is, and it's efficient.
It is a pig.
The happy new for the hubris like me.
Oh,
very strong aroma and flavor from the Taito people.
And the head chef, Shingo-san's background is kind of like a Kaiseki style here, so he's good at it.
The Taito people are great.
The veggies is crunchy and
co-fresh.
It's thin as expected. Crispy, crunchy, and kind of melts in your mouth.
Very fatty.
All right, the chef Shingo, thank you for everything. Everything's so good.
ありがとうございます。
最近シンガポール来たんですよね。半年前にマレーシアから。
その前からやっぱ和食やってたんですか?そうですね、日本でだいたい
13年ほど
13年、海水プロベース お任せ全部美味しいんですけど、どのメニューが一番気合い入れたとかありますか?
そうですね、鉄板スタイルのすき焼き 次のマダイ、最強味噌ソース まあ僕、もともとベースが海水なので
Very sad news, there are only three more dishes left, but to be honest, it's quite a lot.
Oh, and look at this. That's Satsuma Wagyu A4 Tenderloin.
That's the four how big.
The heat is quite amazing.
All right, this is so exciting. Satsuma A4 Tenderloin. Perfectly nice pink color. Connect with a bit of the salt.
Look at how ridiculously tender this meat is, and it's so fruity too, you know?
Next, I'll try this wasabi condiment with garlic chips.
That is just so good. This might be my favorite. It's so tender, sweet, delicious, and I cannot wait for my prepared right now.
And that's my last dish before my dessert.
It just smells so good.
Again, not overpowering. I taste the sweetness of the rice itself. There's always garlic fried rice and teppanyaki. Same here, very nice flavor and aroma.
So garlicky, incredibly crispy. And of our miso soup.
In the dessert, there's this beautiful plate of goodies. We got black sesame tofu, yuzu ice cream, and seasonal fruits. We can tell the melon is so juicy.
The melon is really good.
All right, I'm super full. You can see it's already dark now. And I noticed, yeah, it's even nicer in the evening.
It's just so cool to come to this new area.
I've never been here in Singapore. Super cool, and of course, the Teppan-Kaiseki at MIYOSHI by Fat Cow was great too. It's just a great place for celebrations, special occasions, but also good for a normal day too. You can find good deals for a la carte and lunch set menus. As always, more info in the description box below, and don't forget to use my promo. Thank you so much for watching. See you guys again in the next video. 10分なんだ折り合い. Bye bye.